So how does one calculate compound interest? Hi, I'm Jimmy Chang. I've been teaching college math for almost a decade now, and we're here to address exactly that. Compound interest is a very complicated thing in that it uses a couple of formulas, but we're going to use the most commonplace formula today. Even though it is a little bit on the long side, it is a very practical thing in that it lets you figure out how much money you'll have at the end of a certain period in time. Now, here's the common formula that we'll be exploring today. You have a rather involved formula over there, a equals p times in parentheses 1 plus r over n to the nt power. Now, a is the amount. It's how much you want to have at the very end. P stands for principal, how much you'll have at the beginning, how much you're depositing. R is the interest rate. N is the number of times interest is compounded per year. Now, different accounts will have different terms, so n is going to be very important. And T is the time. Time is generally mentioned in years. Now, let's go over a really quick scenario here for you. Suppose you have $3,000 invested. That's $3,000 is your P. Invested at 5%, that's going to be your rate of interest. Over 7 years' time, so T would be 7, and compounded monthly. Now, because there's 12 months out of the year, N is going to be 12. Now, when you plug all those things in, this is what the first line should look like. P is 3,000, N is 12. Notice the two places that N is going to be. Now, when you express a percentage, though, be sure to shift the decimal two places. So 5% should really be 0.05. Now, you're going to need a calculator for this because it's really hard to do all of this in your head. But when you do the math, you'll find that 0.05 divided by 12 is going to give you 0.0042. 12 times 7 over here is going to be 84. Now, you have to add it with a 1, so you have 1.0042. And the key calculation is being able to raise this number to the 84th power. Now, this is where your calculator is going to do the work for you. But when you see that, you're going to have 1.422 as a result, and here's the moment of truth, because you have to multiply that with 3,000 to figure out how much money you'll have at the end of 7 years. And you'll find out, if you plug in your numbers right, that it's going to be $4,265.99, which is quite a lot more than $3,000 that you had to begin with. So I hope this gives you a glimpse as to how this works, and I'm Jimmy Chang, and that is how you calculate compound interest.